Hi guys, I'm Caleb and I'm here to talk to you about sleep tips for college students. And I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, you don't have time for sleep. You have tests, you have quizzes, you have papers. You have a job, you have an internship. You don't have time to sleep. But here's the thing. Young adults need between 7 and 9 hours of sleep. And this is especially important for college students because long-term memories are solidified in sleep. So you can be pulling an all-nighter, but you might not actually be retaining as much information as you would if you'd gotten some sleep. So I'm gonna give you some sleep tips and you can modify them to work in the dorms. Full disclosure, I have never lived in the dorms, so I don't know what it's like, but I did work the night shift for 3 years, so I'm used to sleeping in non-ideal conditions. All right, on to the tips. So tip number one, the bedroom is for sleeping and sex, and that's it. You have to really try to not do anything else in your room because your brain will associate it with activity. Now, I know that's really hard in the dorms, so in that case, don't study in bed. Your brain needs to associate your bed with sleep, so if you're going to do any studying, do it at your desk, do it on the floor, do it in the library, just don't do it in bed. So, sleep tip number two, lay off the caffeine. Now, I know this is difficult, but you should stop drinking caffeine by early afternoon. You might not feel like it's keeping you up, but it actually will disrupt your sleep later. This brings me to sleep tip number three, lay off the alcohol. Now, I know you're thinking that it might make you drowsy, and initially it could make you drowsy, but it's actually disrupting your sleep. It can lead you to waking up more during the night, and even if you're not aware of it, it's disrupting your sleep. Sleep tip number four, make your room a cave. If it's possible, put up blackout curtains. I know you might think that your blinds are doing a perfectly good job at keeping out the light, but they're not. When I worked the night shift, I had 2 pairs of blackout curtains. So I had my pink ones, and then I had black ones behind it, which was the best way to blot out the sun during the day. At nighttime, it's not so important, and the lighter color blackout curtains will work. Now, I understand in the dorms you might not be able to put up blackout curtains, so get yourself an eye mask, a little sleep mask. This can help black out the rest of the sun or your roommate's lamp. If that doesn't work for you when you're sleeping, drape a long sleeve shirt over your eyes. I don't like the feeling of elastic around my head, but if I draped a sleeve over my face, not covering my nose and mouth, I found that I was able to really sleep better. Sleep tip number five. Try and cancel out any noise. I'm pretty lucky. I live in an apartment complex. I live in my own apartment by myself, and the complex is pretty quiet. I know that people that live in the dorms might not be so lucky, or if your neighbors are prone to partying, you could have some problems. That's where earplugs come in. There's a few different types of earplugs, and they come in different sizes, so you might just have to shop around to see what works best for you. Personally, I only use the earplugs if there's parties going on. I just prefer white noise, so I leave my fan on. There's also some great apps that are sound machine apps, so you can listen to things like waves or city noises, even crickets, so that might help.
Sleep tip number six, the cell phone. Now, I know there's studies out there that say that you shouldn't have your phone anywhere near you when you're asleep and that you should put it in a different room. I think that's unrealistic, especially for college students. I personally use my phone as an alarm clock, so it has to be by me when I sleep. But there are two things that you should do when you are asleep with your cell phone in the room. The first is to turn your screen brightness all the way down, and the second is to turn off notifications. Turn off your ringer, anything that makes noise. You might not really be aware of the sound, but it can be waking you up even if you're not aware of it.
And finally, if you find that you really can't sleep, go see your doctor. There could be a reason why you're not falling asleep, and they might be able to prescribe you something to help you out with that.
Anyway, that's all I've got for you, and I hope these tips helped.